ready. I am going to do a little review on a new tire shine product that I have, which is called Rhino Shine. I got this from Rhino Custom Detailing and Films in Huntington Beach, which is owned by Alex Lee, who's a really nice guy. They do a lot of detailing and graphic and film and clear bra stuff there. So I was over there the other day chatting with him a little bit, and he just released a product line recently, which I've heard some pretty reputable detailers are starting to buy up his stuff. He took some products that he liked and then brought them to a chemist to tweak them so that they, you know, have more of the properties he likes. You know, for instance, like this tire shine might have a little bit more pop to it than, I forget exactly what he said, than other stuff. But I thought that was really cool, so I bought a bottle off of him after he did some sticker work on my truck, and I'm gonna give it a try today on this Tesla Model 3 that I just finished coating in Feynlab ceramic lite and doing paint protection film on the front end. So first I've gotta clean the wheel, so bear with me. I'm gonna start with the tire, which as we've been over previously, we wanna make sure that the tire is nice and clean. Now this car only has about 60 miles on it, so it's probably not going to be too bad. So the tire shine should have no problem bonding. I don't think I'm going to need to use any like tar or sap removers like I have in my other video. But I'm going to do two rounds of cleaning the Shine Supply all-purpose cleaner, Shine Supply solution, my all-purpose cleaner, to get the tire nice and clean. So see, there's not really much dirt popping up. This was the first wipe, not a lot of dirt. So I'm satisfied with that. So now I'm gonna spray down the rest of this wheel. Bring the wheel real quick. And those of you who do waterless wash know what a pain in the ass it is to clean wheels by hand without a pressure washer. Gotten pretty good at it, but still not my favorite detailing activity. Especially when you can't reach in to get all the spokes, or to get the barrel for all the spokes. So that wheel is clean to my liking. I'm gonna grab my applicator pad that is used. This was at one point a coating applicator. It is now a tire shine applicator. I have a bunch of these in my detailing tool and towel collection that I just use for, you know, coating plastics or applying trim restore or tire shine. So with the Rhino Shine, you're gonna shake it up. And don't make fun of me, because I know how that probably looked. It's gonna spray, I think that was four spritzes on this applicator. And then it's gonna kinda meld it to the tire, and then go try to do one big swipe. You might wanna go back over in case you missed any spots, like at the bottom of the wheel. And then I didn't load this tire up too much because I don't like when it's like super wet looking. I also don't want it to fling later when the owner of this drives it off. So let me bring it closer so you can kind of check out how nice it looks. So now we'll go to the other side. This is a terrible video shot, I know. So see, this is before, so I'm going to set up here, and we'll clean and do the tire on this wheel as well. two rounds of all-purpose cleaner on the tire. This wheel, I'm gonna put a little bit more product on, so I want to see kind of how wet of a wet look we can get with this stuff. So this applicator already has some tire juice on it, so I'm gonna shake it again. Now I wanna go for like a more of a wet look, so I'm gonna add another four sprays here. So this, I can see I definitely got some excess product, and the tread, which as we all know, would lead to tire flinging. So since that happened, I'm going to take my towel and I'm just going to kind of wipe the tread a little bit wherever I can see stuff pooling up. And I want to add a little more. Looks like this stuff has kind of a limit on how glossy you can get it. Maybe if I came back in an hour after it dried and put more on, it might do that, but I don't feel like waiting an hour for that. So, hold on 1 second here. Here, once again, Rhino Shine from Rhino Detailing. Check them out. If you have any questions about the product, you can hit up Alex Lee, who is the owner there, and I'm sure he'll be more than happy to answer any questions you have. I'm always on the lookout for new products, tire shine, interior cleaners, rinseless washes to do these videos with. So far, I really like this stuff. It looks really nice, and I believe he said it was originally based off of a Meguiar's tire shine, which I already am pretty familiar with that one, and it works very well. So I'm sure this will work even better. So this is definitely worth adding to your arsenal if you are looking for a good tire shine product that doesn't have too much gloss, that's not going to fling everywhere, doesn't just gives you that like new car look but with some shine, or new tire look with some shine. So I definitely recommend picking this up. I think you can get this online from Rhino Detailing's website, which I'm not sure the exact link, but you can just Google Rhino Films and Detailing in Huntington Beach and you should be able to find it. Thank you, Alex, for hooking me up with this product, and hopefully this video that I just dropped this in and didn't damage the sprayer brings you some sales. So I hope you guys enjoyed. If you are not subscribed to my channel, please subscribe for more detailing tips, tricks, and reviews. I'm also going to be soon adding another kind of like TV show segment with driving. So stay tuned for that one as I collect some equipment and come up with some ideas. So yeah, we'll see you next time. Hit the subscribe button and watch some more videos.